everybody. Welcome to Wake County Public Library's online story time. My name is Miss Tracy, and I'm so happy that you're tuning in today. We are going to be doing a preschool story time today, and I hope you're ready for fun because Miss Tracy loves to have fun in her story times. Before we get started, I just want to remind you that Wake County Public Libraries base all of our story times on Every Child Ready to Read initiative. There are 5 pre-literacy skills. There's talking, singing, reading, writing, and playing. And these are the things we like to practice in story time. In case you ever forget what those 5 things are, there's a song to help you remember, and it goes, talk, sing, read, write, and play. We can do it every day. Great job, everybody. We're going to start by using our singing skill. So can you warm up your voices for me? Me, 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 me. Great job. We are going to sing our hello song today. This is one of my favorites. It's called Bread and Butter, Marmalade and Jam. And to do this, you need to know just a few things. We will practice saying hello 5 different ways. We are going to say it loudly, quietly, quickly, slowly, and as nicely as we can. And there's a rhythm that we like to do, an alternating rhythm that goes lap, clap, lap, clap. And that's all you need to know. But before we start singing, I just want you to be mindful of your surroundings. So when you sing as loudly as you can, just be aware of any maybe sleeping siblings or some animals. You don't want to scare them, okay? Are you ready to sing with me? Here we go. Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. Let's say hello as loudly as we can. Hello! Great job. Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. Let's say hello as quietly as we can. Shh. Hello. Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. Let's say hello as quickly as we can. Hello. Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. Let's say hello as slowly as we can. Hello. Great job. Are you ready for one more? Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. Let's say hello as nicely as we can. Hello. Great singing, everybody. And now that we've said hello to one another, I brought a special story time friend with me today. Her name is Pepper the dog, and she has a very special part in our story time. Can you say hi, Pepper? Woo! Good job, Pepper. She's not shy at all, are you? She's certainly not. Well, Pepper has a very important job in story time. She brings with her our letter of the day, but, so Pepper has done something extra special for you today. She brought a backpack with her, is that right? She did, and that backpack not only has our letter of the day in it, but some clues to figure out what our theme is. That was so kind of you. Yes, it was. So now that Pepper has done most of her job, I'm going to put her down so we can grab her backpack. But can you all wave goodbye to Pepper? Can you wave bye-bye? Great job. And Pepper, can you wave goodbye to our friends? Can you wave bye? Good job. Can you say bye-bye? Good job. We'll see her a little bit later, but let's see what backpack she brought with us today. We'll rest her right here. And I've got Pepper's super fun spring backpack, and I almost forgot. We can't figure out our letter of the day until we sing our ABC song. Do you think you can help me sing that song? Great. So when I count to 3, can you help me sing? 1, 2, 3. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. H-I-J-K-L-M-N-O-P-Q-R-S-T-U-V-W-X-Y-N-Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me? Great job singing, and let's see. Ah, I see our letter in here. Let me pull it out and see. Do you recognize this letter? Very good, it's the letter S. I'm gonna put that right on our board here. A purple letter S is our letter of the day. Do you know any words that begin with the letter S? Snake, very good. And the S makes the snake sound, very good. Strawberry, that's such a big word. Good for you. And yes, that's another S word. And does anybody have a name that begins with an S? Steven, maybe, Sarah? There are lots of words and names that begin with the letter S. And we've got one word today that's going to be our story time theme. And like Pepper told me, there's some clues inside here that will let us know what our theme is. Let's take a look inside. Let me see. What is this? It looks like the moon, only a lot smaller version of the moon. Does moon begin with the letter S? No, it begins with the letter M. Very good. So a moon, let me see if there's anything. There is. Do you recognize this? A star, and star begins with the letter S, our letter of the day. Moon, star. I wonder what our theme is. Let me see. There's one more in here. See what this is. Do you recognize this? A rocket ship. Let's see. So we've got a moon, a star, and a rocket ship. What do you think our S word is today? Very good. Space. How many of you would like to go to space with Miss Tracy today? Can you raise your hand? Great. Well, that is what we are going to do. But before we go to space, I think it's important for us to get ready for our first story. And we're going to do a little dance to a song called Dance, Freeze, Melt. And that's really all you need to know. You need to dance, freeze, and then melt all the way down to the ground. Are you ready to dance with me? All right, here we go.
Dance, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, freeze.
Jumping, everybody.
Six, seven, eight.
Way down to the ground. Great job, everybody. And now that you've melted all the way down to the ground, we are going to get ready for our first space story. And this is a story called Penguinaut. It's about a penguin who is an astronaut. How silly is that? Well, I hope that you enjoy the story Penguinaut by Marcy Colleen. Here we go. Orville was small. His friends were big. See who's Orville's friend. I see a big gray trunk and a white tusk. An elephant. Good job. And their adventures were bigger. Orville longed for big adventures too. One day, he announced his plans for the biggest and best adventure yet. Orville's big adventure to the moon. Ta-da! Is that a good idea? All the way up there?
But Orville, you're so small.
And the moon is so far away. I can do this myself, Orville flippered out. He tried to flap, kerplop. He tried to climb, whack. He tried to catapult, fling, and landed in the reptile house. Orville was pretty sure Boa Constrictor was not trying to hug him. But still, Orville kept trying. He borrowed from the zookeeper. He nicked from trash cans. He built and built. What do you think Orville might be building? Let's see. I think you might be right. It might be a rocket ship. Let's see. And there it is. And with a shake, shake, shake of a half-filled soda bottle, the ship was ready for liftoff. It was perfect and perfectly penguin-sized. With a trembling flipper salute, he took his place at the controls. I can do this myself. 3, 2, 1. Blast off. Whoosh. The ship zipped through the night sky, through clouds, over stars, and straight to the moon. Orville landed. Kaboom. His stomach felt queasy. His spacesuit felt squeezy. Now that he'd made it, what would he do? Wonder what he's going to do on the moon. Let's see. He took a small step. He hopped, did a little dance, and tripped. Tumble, bumble, bubbling. He somersaulted with stars, cartwheeled over craters, and giggled for the galaxy to hear. It was the biggest and best adventure yet. I'm doing it myself, he cheered, but his tiny voice was swallowed up in the starry blackness. Orville stopped. He was all alone. How do you think Orville might be feeling? He might be scared, sad, very lonely, you're right. His stomach grew queasier, his spacesuit grew squeezier. He shivered, and a note fell out of his pocket. The note said, "You're our penguinaut. We know you can do this." Oh, so sweet, his friend sent him a note. He missed his friends, so Orville closed his eyes tightly and imagined they were there. He turned the stars into his friends. Look, there's elephant and snake and lion and giraffe. When he was safely back in his ship, he looked toward home. He couldn't wait to tell everyone about his big adventure. Sure, Orville's friends were big. Now the proud penguinaut felt big too. But biggest of all, being together was out of this world. 3, 2, 1. And that was our story, Penguinaut, by Marcy Colleen. And now we are going to play a little game. When Orville went to the moon, he saw lots of bright, shining stars. And we have a mission. We are also going to travel to the moon and try to find us a star. I brought with me a few different colored moons. As I put them up on my board here, feel free to shout out the colors that you see, okay? Here we go, we've got blue, great. Green comes next. Yellow. Purple, great. And pink. There, she stayed. Okay, that pink moon. Alrighty, so in order to find our star, we are going to sing a little song. So we're gonna make stars with our hands just like that. And we're going to sing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, How I Wonder Where You Are. Where should we look? Let's see. Let's try the under the green moon. One, two, three. No star there. Should we keep looking? We should. Okay. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder where you are. Where should we look next? Maybe the bright yellow moon? Good choice. Let's look here. We'll count. One, two, three. No moon, no star there. Let's see. Where should we look next? Blue, like blue moon? Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder where you are. Let's look under the blue moon, okay? One, two, three. Oh, no star there. I'm getting awfully nervous. What if we can't find our star? I'm gonna feel so sad. We've got only two moons left. Where should we look? Purple? Okay, let's try the purple one. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder where you are. Are you under the purple moon? One, two, three. No star there. Oh my, we only have one moon left. What if we cannot find our star? Oh, so I don't even know if I can look. Okay, should we just count to three and see if it's there? Yes, okay. I'm gonna close my eyes. I can't look. Okay. One, two, three. Is it there? Yay! Good job, everybody. Our star was hiding under our pink moon, our happy little star. We'll leave her there to hang out for the rest of our story time. You guys did a great job. And now we are going to get dressed for our travel to the moon. And to do this, we are gonna put on four articles of very important clothing. We are going to put on our spacesuit. We're gonna go zip. Good job. Then we are going to put on our moon boots and we'll stomp our feet. Then our helmet, so you'll tap your head. And then lastly, we'll put on our gloves and we'll just clap our hands. And this is a song that is sung to if you're happy and you know it, only it's if you're going to the moon and you know it. So here we go. If you're going to the moon, wear your suit, zip. If you're going to the moon, wear your suit, zip. If you're going to the moon and you want to get there soon, if you're going to the moon, wear your suit, zip. If you're going to the moon, wear your boots. If you're going to the moon, wear your boots. If you're going to the moon and you want to get there soon, if you're going to the moon, wear your boots. If you're going to the moon, wear your helmet. If you're going to the moon, wear your helmet. If you're going to the moon and you want to get there soon, if you're going to the moon, wear your helmet. If you're going to the moon, wear your gloves. If you're going to the moon, wear your gloves. If you're going to the moon and you want to get there soon, if you're going to the moon, wear your gloves. Great job, everybody. And now that we are dressed and ready, we are going to go to the moon. This next song we are going to sing is called Zoom, 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 We're Going to the Moon. If you're not familiar with it, that is okay. We're going to do this one two times. The first time will be like a practice run, and then the second time will be our big performance. So here we go. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. Zoom, 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 we'll be there very soon. If you want to take a trip, climb aboard my rocket ship and zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. And we're gonna count down from five and get really low. Five, four, three, two, one, blast off! Great job! But now you've gotta do an even bigger blast off. Are you ready? All right, here we go. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. Zoom, 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 we'll be there very soon. If you want to take a trip, climb aboard my rocket ship and zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. Five, four, three, two, one, blast off! Great job, everybody! And now that we've traveled to the moon, we are going to do a little dance to one of my favorite songs called Rocket Ship Run. We're going to travel to the sun and go spinning on the sun. We're going to dance on the moon, and we are going to jump on the stars. Here we go. Are you ready?
Five, four, three, two, one, blast off, another rocket ship run. Five, four, three, two, one, blast off, another rocket ship run.
Take me
to the sun. Take me to the sun.
We're gonna go spinning on the sun. Here we go.
When I get there, I'll go spinning through the air, spinning round the rocket ship run. Five, four, three, two, one, blast off, another rocket ship run.
Take me to the moon. Down low for the moon.
Take me to the moon.
Can you dance on the moon?
When
here we go.
I get there, I'll go dancing through the air. Dancing.
Good dancing,
on
everybody.
The moon.
Good jumping! There's so many stars! Here we go!
Five, four, three, two, one, blast off, another rocket ship run. Five, four, three, two, one, blast off, another rocket ship run.
We're gonna get down really low. We're going to get ready for our biggest blast off. We're going to count down from 10, okay? Let's get up 10 fingers. Here we go.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off, another rocket ship run.
Great job, everybody. Fabulous blast off. You guys did a wonderful, wonderful job. And it's time for us to get ready for our next story and our final story. So, everybody take a seat, take a seat, take a seat. Everybody take a seat on the floor. Not on the ceiling, not on the door. Everybody take a seat on the floor. Not on the ceiling, not on the door. Everybody take a seat on the floor. Great job. And of course, you can also sit in your couch or on a chair. And we're ready for our final space story. Are you all ready? This is a story called Roaring Rockets. And here we go. Wow! Rockets have power. They rise and roar. This rocket's waiting, ready to soar. Rockets carry astronauts with cool white suits, oxygen helmets, and moon boots. The countdown is finishing. 3, 2, 1, whoosh! Action blasts off, the journey's begun. And there go our friends in their rocket. Rockets have fuel in great big tanks. When they are empty, they drop away. Thanks. Up in space, you're really light, so astronauts need to buckle up tight. Looks like Bird is really strapped in there. Rockets go far, through space they zoom, reaching as far as the big round moon. Down comes the lander with legs out ready and fiery boosters to hold it steady. There it is, they're making a lunar lander. Here we go. Out come the astronauts to plant their flag and scoop up samples in their moon rock bag. Wow-wee! Boing, boing. Rockets explore, through space they roam, but when they're done, they head back home. Rockets re-enter in a fiery flash to land in the sea with a sizzling splash. The helicopter carries the brave crew away. 3 cheers for the astronauts. Hip, hip, hooray! And that was Roaring Rockets. You guys did a great job today. Can you give yourselves a big hip, hip, hooray? Hip, hip, hooray! Fabulous. Well, we are going to get ready to say goodbye today, and I hope that you had as much fun as I did today. It was a blast. And before we say goodbye, I just want to remind you to keep talking, singing, reading, writing, and playing every single day. Let's put our waving hands up and get ready to sing goodbye. Goodbye, my friends, goodbye. Goodbye, my friends, goodbye. Goodbye, my friends, goodbye, my friends. Goodbye, my friends, goodbye. Great job. We'll see you soon. Have a great day.